Om Namah Shivaya. Yoga, when you hear this word, lot of physical exercises and lot of asanas comes in your mind, and so many people are claiming that they are practicing yoga for so many years, and when I come to know what part of the yoga they are practicing is asana, Surya Namaskar, and that's all, making body slim, healthy, and that's all. But today I would like to tell you the area of yoga is much more wider than you can imagine. It's not only limited to the body you can see, but also it's beyond the boundaries of those energies which you cannot see and which you cannot feel today. But someday, if you are lucky enough, the day will come when you will be feeling connected to the universe, when you will be feeling connection with the whole cosmic energies. So today I am going to explain you all 8 parts of yoga one by one. According to the ancient yoga text, this explanation is not according to me, not according to my own understanding, but what I studied through the text, I am going to tell you today. So there are 8 parts: yam, niyam, asan, pranayam, pratyahar, dharana, dhyan, and samadhi. Now one by one we will try to understand what is the meaning of one step and the other step, and how they are connected, and what is the significance of those steps in yoga practice. First is yam. Yam have 5 parts: ahimsa, satya, asteya, brahmacharya, aparigraha, yamaha, means non-violence, truth, non-stealing, non-possession. Ahimsa is non-violence, satya is truth, asteya means non-stealing, aparigraha is non-possession, brahmacharya is controlling over the senses. These are the 5 yamas. When you practice, it's the connection you have with the society, because non-violence, when you have non-violence in your behavior, when you have non-violence in your personality, it will affect others in some way or in many ways. Ahimsa satya means truth. It will definitely affect others. The way you behave, the way you speak, the way you think, or the way you take the things, it should be truthful. Ahimsa satya asteya, non-stealing, means keep your own limits. If I have something, it belongs to me. If you have something, you own that. We should have that very clear thinking. So that is asteya. Aparigraha means non-possession. If I need one, I have one. That is aparigraha. I need one, but I have 100. That is against the yoga rule. So it will disturb the peace of mind. That's why this is an important rule. You should have aparigraha. Means you have what you need, not more than that. And brahmacharya. Brahmacharya, literal meaning of brahmacharya means dissolving yourself into the universe. And how do you dissolve yourself? You need to control your senses physically, mentally, then you will attain the state of brahmacharya. Brahmacharya is not only limited to the body. It's not the English word celibacy. It's not limited to celibacy only. You become celibatic and you claim that you are a brahmacharya. No, you have to understand those energies which is coming from the 5 senses, and then only those 5 senses will help you in the next step of the yoga. The second is niyam. Niyam again have 5 parts: shoj, santosh, tap, swadhyay, and ishwar pranidhan. Shoj means cleansing. Now we have completely opposite side of yama. Yama, each part belongs to others, belongs to society, belongs to the place you come from, because it belongs to the behavior. But niyama belongs to your own cleansing. Cleansing not only the body part, but also the mental and the spiritual cleansing. Niyama, shoj means cleansing, detoxification, santosh, satisfaction. Again, it belongs to you. It has nothing to do with the others. When you are satisfied, it will make you happy. Shoj, santosh, tapaha. Tapa means not only physical work, but involve yourself mentally in that depth where you have no positive or negative aspects left, where you have no opinion left because you are so focused on something. That is tapa. Shoj, santosh, tapa, swadhyaya. This is very beautiful and very important. Swadhyaya means self-study. Some people say swadhyaya means study of the books, but that is not going to bring you anywhere. Even you bring whole library in your head, but still you will be staying there, but it will do something negative. It will bring your ego higher and higher. So the meaning of swadhyaya means self-study. Am I doing better than yesterday? Am I getting some improvement? If you have answer of these questions, that is the meaning of swadhyaya. And the last is shoj, santosh, tap, swadhyaya, ishwar pranidhan. Ishwar pranidhan means convert your energy from other things, the worldly things, the materials, and focus on the universe. Focus on the cosmic energy which is hidden in you. And when you pass these 10 steps, then you are eligible to enter in asan. Asan means sthiram sukham asanam. When you are stable, when you are pleasureful, that state of body is asan. It could be any position. It could be any position. You are not limited to some certain type of positions. Of course, every asana have therapeutic and psychological benefits, but still you have to move forward. Don't stop. The path is so long and it's very beautiful. When people start practicing yoga, they feel so good when they practice asana. They forget that they have to move forward. This is like a door, a beautiful door, but you don't have to stop here. Keep moving forward. Asana. And another is pranayama. Pranayama is like a bridge between body and mind. How you are going to reach spirituality, how you are going to attain the ultimate truth, and how you are going to feel connection with the whole universe, that is pranayama. That is breathing. When you breathe in, breathe out. When you focus too much on your breathing, when you go so deep inside, it will make you realize that you are not only limited to this body. Something else is there. Something else is there which is definitely capable to bring so much peace of mind in you. That is pranayama. Pranayama means expansion of breathing. Expand, when you extend the breathing throughout the body, and then that energy is capable to raise your energy from down to upward. And then pratyahar. Pratyahar is very beautiful. We have 5 senses. The whole senses are diverting outside. From my eyes I can see, from my skin I can feel, from my ear I can hear the sound. But we have to convert the direction from outside to inside. When they move towards inside, that is pratyahara, dharana. When the energy is inside, when you move it from outside to inside, they will have dharana. You will have something there. You will have something to hold. You will have a target. When you have target, that will become dhyan. Dhyan means, in English, they call it meditation. But meditation, not doing so justification with the word dhyan. Dhyan is very beautiful word. Dhyan is when two are there, you and that. You and that energy. Still, two is there. But in the next step, samadhi, you dissolve yourself. You dissolve yourself, not physically yet, but mentally and spiritually. You dissolve, you mix up, you become part of this whole universe. That is meditation. That is another next level of meditation, that is samadhi. Samadhi means finding the solution. Finding the solution of what? There must be some problem, so you need to find the solution. The problem is from the birth until the moment you are sitting here and you are listening my voice. Because you have some problems, that's why those problems brings you here. So be honest with yourself, at least now, that you have some problems. If you accept the problem part, we can go to the solution part. And the solution is samadhi. I hope this explanation will help you to understand yoga in a better way. And thank you so much.